Would you mind turning this mic off just while I'm sitting here? Thank you. Festival, this group was awarded a gold medal. Round applause for these students. Let them on a band made up of primarily freshmen. They've been a fantastic group to work with. I love the attendance of this group. They're in school all the time and very few absences. But first of all, a big shout out to John Whitehead back in August for putting me to the fact that yesterday was not a good day to have a concert. So the fact that we moved it because of the eclipse, John, thank you for giving us that heads up. So you can get the program notes here, but Cenotaph is our first piece. We've been working on articulation a lot. It's a pretty contemporary piece, and it's pretty short. Cenotaph is a monument that is dedicated to somebody who is not buried in that place. So I think you'll see that portrayed in this piece. Enjoy. And just to make a point here, we are super fortunate in our schedule here at Westbrook that this band meets separately. The percussionists get their own class to learn all the things that are required of percussion at the high school level. So the winds and the percussion do not rehearse together. They're playing fantastic for never playing together. Nice job so far, everybody. I say that because down the country lane requires almost no percussionists. There's a little bit of percussion in the back, so please don't think that these children just sit here as we rehearse this. They're actually not in the class at all. So you can see the program notes on Down the Country Lane. I urge you to read them if you have not yet. It's quite interesting. That's an extremely hard piece of music for them, and you guys did a fantastic job on that. Thank you so much. The final piece with the concert band is a piece called Blue Ridge Reel. So this is from the Appalachian Mountains, and a reel is a dance that continues and repeats and repeats. And we have some super cool percussion instruments back there. I especially would like you to listen to two of them. First of all, Grace, would you play the washboard, please? Okay, so that's like an old school washboard since before electricity and things like that. And then Alexa, would you play the spoons for us? Would you raise your hand if you can hear the spoons? Do it again, please. Everybody hear the spoons okay? Okay, great. We have the mic with them so we can hear them. But we were going to do the cheater way. We're going to actually like do the right thing. So raise your hand if this is your favorite piece of the three. Right, so a number of students really like this one. Hope you do too. Blue Ridge Reel. But it's going to be well worth it. So, State of Maine Song March is a piece that is very special for our state. Maybe I should wait for ready. What we call a symphonic band in Westbrook, we don't really do the symphonic band thing. We have two sort of concert band and one ensemble, so students are more at ability level and experience level. The nice thing about a group like this, when we do get to put together, is younger students get to sit near older students, and you hear there's a difference in the sound of a band when there's 70 people playing rather than when there's 30 people. It's not better or worse, it's just a little bit thicker. So we're really excited to be able to do this. So you'll see in the program notes here, first of all, round of applause for our composer on this, Heather Hastings. Heather's in the building, I believe, Heather Maria. Thank you so much for being here. So I'm going to read this. I want to make sure everybody sort of has an idea with this. This main state song, March, I know Miss Prue is of the generation that learned this in class, like we learned the Yankee Doodles and St. Kevin's is our state. Round of applause if you learned this song when you were younger. Couple, check, great. I did not know it, so I'm happy to be learning. Roger Minton Snow was from Falmouth, and he was a lawyer. And he submitted this song to the Publicity Bureau Song Competition in 1931 and won that competition. So in 1937, the Maine legislature adopted the Maine state song as the official state song of Maine. Maine composer Heather Hastings has adapted this song to fit in the March style, adding composed elements, giving hints of the famous Stars and Stripes Forever by John Philip Sousa. So this is partially an arrangement and partially a composition, but we're really excited because as you see on the program, this is a world premiere. This is the first time this piece is being played live in public. No pressure, students. Okay, hope you enjoy the Maine state song March. Salute. This year you'll hear, when Johnny comes marching home, otherwise known as the Ensemble Marching 2x2, you'll hear it seven times throughout, so make sure you keep track of that. Once you've heard the seventh one, then you know the piece is about to be over. So it was earlier in the year, and for some reason, I'm a dad, if you don't know, and my wife and kids were both gone, I found myself home alone. So as a classic dad, I found myself watching Die Hard 3, of course, because it was on TV and I own it and I never watch it, but I'll have to watch it if it's on TV. Anyway, the middle part of that, the bad guy theme is this tune, and it reminded me of this great gold arrangement of this piece. So literally, I got the idea to play this with our one ensemble because of Die Hard. So if Bruce Willis is watching anywhere, thank you very much for the inspiration.
Thank you.
group, because you'll notice there's some students who change instruments every time, and they want to make sure it's working and they're ready to go before we play the piece. My takeaway from the hymn song of Philip Bliss, which the hymn song is titled "It's Well With My Soul," this piece was written in the face of terrible, terrible tragedy, and this person's outlook on life is really wonderful, even in the midst of all these bad things that happened to him and his family. So if you're not sure about the origin of it, go check it out. It's a fantastic piece, highly emotional. Enjoy it.
Thank you.
So this next piece, and we have two left, thank you again for being a great audience. This next piece takes some explaining, because if you didn't know what was going on, you have zero idea what you're listening to. This piece is called a contemporary aleatoric piece. So there's times when there's just a lot of batty, crazy things happening. What are some of the weird things that are happening? Well, we have a water gong, that's cool. So you play a gong, you dip it into water, so that's gonna give us a cool sound. We have a lion's roar, which is a drum with a rope through it. We have crystal glasses. They are not just staying hydrated up here, these glasses are actually for them to make the inappropriate table sounds that we're using for the piece called crystals. And you'll notice the different movements. The dark ice movement combines water sounds and the modal melodies to suggest the mystery and terrible majesty of a glacier, iceberg, and things in under them. The second section, called Underwater Rubies, uses water sounds to describe a sunken treasure. And in that one, you're gonna hear like an in the distance underwater march between the bass drum, the cymbals, and the gong. That's a really cool section. The cyanide section is a violent and percussive spirit, which by its brevity mimics the horrible potency of its namesake. And finally, monolith aspires to a huge vertical space, large sweeps of color, and a sturdy brass foundation for those masses of crystals such as Stonehenge in England or any natural promontory. So I hope you enjoy the four sections of crystals. Thank you. two things they're not as comfortable doing. So not all of them would say that was their favorite piece, but there are some who did say it was their favorite piece, which was kind of cool. Raise your hand if you were able to hear some the different sections and kind of what it was trying to portray. Awesome, great. Okay, our final piece is by a great composer, David Maslanka. Most of this music is for more experienced groups. This is a fantastic piece called Illumination. Again, means bringing to light. So we really wanted to end with a really uplifting piece here. And it's one of those pieces that when you finish it, it's really hard to play anything else afterwards. So hope you enjoy it. Again, a big round of applause for all the students on stage and sitting here. And I know you know this, but as a parent, I completely appreciate everything everybody in this room does. Whether it's, you know, all the things, without parent support, children, you have no idea how lucky you are to have parents who are supporting you in this and here to watch you and all that. So parents, thank you so much from the bottom of our heart. It really means a lot to us. very much for attending.